Shifting gears now, September is known to be Childhood Cancer Awareness Month, and one mother whose own son suffered from leukemia is helping to spread the word about the disease and raise funds for other struggling families with her book, I Am Kenzo Brave. For more on the book, we are joined by Kat Del Rosario Cruz, the author of I Am Kenzo Brave. Good morning, Kat. Thank you so much for joining us.
Hi, Nikki. Good morning. Good morning, everybody. Thanks for having me.
All right. So September is, as said, Childhood Cancer Awareness Month. Tell us first about this journey up to wellness of Kenzo and how its story fits well into the month's theme.
Yes. So in November of 2018, when Kenzo was just 22 months old, he was diagnosed with acute lymphoblastic leukemia. And that's when our cancer journey as a family really started.
And this came about from an IG post first, right? Tell us how it came to be an actual book.
Yes. So originally, it was just a story that I wrote for Kenzo, you know, something that he can look back to for him to remember how brave he was. And then I posted it on Instagram, and my now publisher from Quartel PH picked it up and asked if, you know, I wanted to publish it as a children's book.
How important are stories like these to children experiencing such diseases?
Well, in my opinion, it's very important for kids to read about stories like Kenzo's because it helps them to not feel so alone. Because as what me and my family have experienced with Kenzo, a cancer diagnosis can be very, shall we say, parang it leaves you out of the loop, you know, with your friends, with your family, especially those who haven't really experienced it. So I think this book can help other kids know and feel that they are not alone.
And could you also tell us about the people involved in this, from the story input to the book's design and art?
Yes.
How much of it did you have a hand in?
Okay, so the story itself, I wrote all of it. It's really based on Kenzo's journey talaga. And then, as I've mentioned earlier, I'm sorry, I'm not sure if it was heard earlier, but my publisher is from Quartel PH. Our layout artist is Mr. Sam Maralit, and our illustrator, who did a really fine job at capturing what I had in mind when I wrote this story, is Mr. Pio Tendero, who is an art teacher at Ateneo de Manila.
And who will be the beneficiaries of the book?
50% of the net proceeds from all book sales will go towards initiatives for the benefit of kids with cancer. So that's in partnership with Kite Foundation. And through them, we hope to be able to give financial aid to children with cancer. And we also have a project which is very close to my heart. I'll show it very quickly. It's called the Zip-a-Tops, which are regular t-shirts fitted with zippers like this for port-a-cat implantees like Kenzo. So this will make the accessing of the port easier for them. They won't have to remove their shirts anymore.
All right. And where do we get a copy of the book? Is it also available online?
Yes. So for everybody who wants to know more about I Am Kenzo Brave, you may visit www.iamkenzobraveph.com or visit at I Am Kenzo Brave on Instagram.
Kat, do you have an upcoming book signing event scheduled soon so that we can perhaps meet you and, of course, Kenzo?
Yes, on Sunday, we actually have an event called Books and Brunch. It will be held at Rafael's Tapas Bar and Restaurant at Resorts World Manila from 11 a.m. Onwards. That's on Sunday.
And lastly, before we let you go, Pat, how is Kenzo doing?
He's doing well. Thank you so much for asking. His oncology team continues to monitor him. So we do go to the hospital once a month for blood work and for fourth flushing. And in October, he will have a bone marrow aspiration since it marks his first year of treatment.
It's such a brave, strong
kid. So we're really hoping for positive results.
All right, we'll pray for you guys. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, Kat. You and your family, stay safe.